Greetings from Cybertron. This is SoundJack here with a review of the Transformers Combiner Wars Deluxe Class Protectobot Groove. So Protectobot Groove is the last of the three figures that I got at TFCon that I still have in the package. Protectobot Groove was an interesting figure. This is the Deluxe Class version of the figure. There was a Legends one released that went with Defensor predominantly because they were like, you know what, it's a little weird to have a motorcycle be a limb for a combiner that has, you know, a helicopter and a police car as other limbs. So they decided to downsize him and make Rook a thing to make that more sensical. But then Japan decided to release their Defensor with Groove, with a deluxe-sized Groove rather than the new buddy on the block, Rook. And Hasbro released it in the U.S. as a special part of their May Mayhem stuff, if I recall correctly, where they had, and the previous year, at a different May Mayhem, they also released Breakneck, which is supposed to be Wild Rider, and Quickslinger, which is supposed to be Slingshot. But I don't get those yet, and I saw this and was like, oh yeah, let's get that. Let's see how this works, and I got to figure out if I actually want him on my Defensor. I probably will end up him and Rook just being cool by himself, dude. But anyway, let's take a look at the packaging itself. Much smaller than the other figures I've reviewed. But he is a bit clunkily placed in there because he's got this giant wheels and his legs have to split off, and then you got the hand-foot gun for the combiner limbs, and then you got his two pistols there. Combine to form! That's not Defensor. That's not Defensor, that's Skyrain. Hold on, we gotta still finish looking at the front. There's motorcycle mode, you get a collector's card with Groove. There's Protectobot Groove, ages 8+. He is 4 or 5 of Skyrain, I guess, and there's some artwork of Skyrain. There's nothing on this side, you just say Groove in the back, you just get Transformers on the side. On the back of the box, you got a very brief bio of Protectobot Groove, some stock photography, and shows that he can form the right leg of Skyrain. Though that should also be his placement for Defensor. Don't know why they did that, but yeah, he can also become an arm as well. And on the bottom of the box, it's just info and stuff, authentic Transformers. Yeah, but that's all there is for Protectobot Groove in his box. So, I'm going to get a model box and then we're going to review him. Just give me a moment. And here we have Groove out of the box and in his motorcycle mode. It's a very nice motorcycle mode, a very large motorcycle mode, but a very nice motorcycle mode. Nonetheless, you come up to the front, you got some nice silver detailing on, some molding and silver paint going on underneath this clear plastic. If the camera will focus on that, and you can see that, and then you get some clear red plastic up here for the siren lights. You got some clear blue going on for the windscreen, and a nice Autobot symbol with a silver border. I'm not sure what these are called. I'd like to say pistons, but I'm certain that's wrong. It's just, but these things that hold this front wheel together are just solid white. But the wheel is nice, being black with some nice tire molding on it, and silver painted hubcaps or rims or whatever. You come to the side, it gets a little clunky and it's a lot of robot. You got the arms just sticking out right there, but you do get this kickstand, a very tiny, very white kickstand going on there. Like I said, just a lot of motorcycle, a lot of robot stuff going on there. You got some handlebars up here and a little bit of like a dashboard, chronometer probably there somewhere. You do have police written on the side of the motorcycle. You got the police going on. You got the police going on there. Police going on the other side. There's a lot of black on top. Kind of bit of a molded in, kind of a steep thing. In the back, you get a little bit, some bits of red for the taillights. And then the back wheel also has the same stuff going on with the front wheel. And then just a lot of robot going on. So he is able to roll. Both wheels do roll, as you can see. However, because of how the transformation works, this front wheel
rolls pretty freely, while the back one just you get it to move, but it just doesn't go anywhere just because there's so much going on with how the transformation works. There's just so much friction putting pressure on that. And you get articulation because you get that kickstand that can fold in and out. Yeah, and that's the vehicle mode, so let's get on to the accessories. He comes with these two gun weapons. They seem to be molded in clear plastic, though the top here is in red to be like sirens on his guns, and then the rest is painted this nice gunmetal kind of gray silver going on here. It's a very nice, and also has some sparkly kind of pink going on, and it's very nice. It's very nice, but you can see it's based in clear plastic because of the handles, the handle ports on there. And they are mirrors of each other. They're mirrors. This side is hollow, and the other side, well, not that hollow, but it's mostly how the pegs are placed. But they are able to store on the vehicle mode, and they can store by tabbing them into the sides of the rear wheel. And while you get a couple more lights for the motorcycle, you also get exhaust pipes for the motorcycle. since it wouldn't have those without them, without these guns on there, so you get those, and that looks pretty neat. And then you also get Groove. And then you get the Combiner Wars hand foot gun thing, because it is a gun, it becomes the Combiner hand, and it becomes the Combiner foot. But we are looking at it as a gun right now. It has two miniguns going on for its knuckles and for its weaponry, and it's got the standard stuff. It's got this hinge is white. It's got the peg. There's some rivet details going on there. You can see the hand bits and all of that stuff. And this also is able to store on the motorcycle mode. There is a hole at the top right there, and you can plug that in, and you are able to effectively store all of the accessories he comes with on the vehicle mode, which is a nice touch. It's nice that he is able to do that. But and you can swap pieces. This can go on the top, this can go on the side, all that you want to do, because you can display it however you want. But now let's get into some size comparisons. Here he is with Legends Class Bumblebee. That's not in scale at all. That's not in scale at all, gotta say. Here he is with Deluxe Class Chrome Dome. And Groove is longer and certainly taller, but definitely thinner. Definitely thinner than Chrome Dome is. Here he is with Voyager class Megatron, if you don't fall over. Okay, never mind. Megatron is just longer, pretty much, compared to Groove, but again, Groove is so much thinner. If Groove will stay standing, then we can compare him with Leader class Six Shot as soon as he parks. And then you can see that comparison there. Alright, we're going to roll right along to the robot mode now, but we are going to make a couple of stops to take a look at his limb configurations for since he is part of the Combiner Wars toy line. We're going to stop and take peeks at his limb forms as we go about this day. So what's going to happen? We're going to start with the foot, because it's very easy to get to the foot from this position. So what's going to happen is we're going to untab the arms. They have tabs right there that will go into slots there and then there, respectively. And then we're going to rotate the... we're not going to untransform the legs. We are going to rotate the arms to the sides and then have these slots go into fit. These tabs go into the slots, and those are in the arms right there.
That's all gonna fit together like that. Repeat that on the other side. That all collapses together. And then we're gonna take the front of the motorcycle, these tabs peg into those holes right there. I'm gonna take it, we're gonna rotate it, and we are going to collapse it down like so. And that all does lock into place very nicely. Then we're gonna take Groove's head, we're gonna rotate it, and we are going to, well actually we gotta untab this so we can get the head to flip around properly. And then we take the hand foot gun, we flip what is going to be the heel out, stick it into the bottom of the vehicle, and boom, you got yourself a leg mode. You got yourself the leg mode of Groove, and it's what you'd expect as much as you, it's what you could do with a motorcycle to get into leg mode. It's got a nice front going on with the motorcycle bit, and then you got some wheel going on in the back. And you got the toe, and does the standard thing. I say it does the standard thing, but I haven't actually reviewed any Combiner Wars figures, so I do have to go over what kind of articulation this thing would have in its foot mode. It's got this, this is where it combines with the combiner, so this is on a heavy ratchet, so it's able. So the leg is able to rotate and is able to bend in and out on that hinge, and able to get to 90 degrees because of it. The foot, because of its how it's tapped in, it can rotate 360, it can bend that far down. The heel has ways to move, and you can also bend the heel down as well. But you don't get a whole lot of articulation out because it is just a leg. Now we're going to keep moving on, and then we are going to get into the arm mode. So we're just going to pull the foot off for now. You could probably keep that on, but I'm just going to take it off for now. We're going to pull the arms out and just get them out of the way for the time being. Actually, we're going to come down here really quick and rotate that base around, and then just pull the connector peg to the side like that, and then Groove's head is still hidden. We're going to move that out of the way for the moment, and we are going to come down here and pull what was the seat off. There are two slots for those two tabs right there, and that's how that connects. And you're going to unaccordion the legs from there, and then those tabs at the back of they won't be the robot no the needs, but anyway, those tabs right there will go into the slots right there, and that will all collapse and connect together. And actually technically we're going to split the wheels up and fold them to the side like that, and you are able to do that without pulling it all apart. It's probably better if you pull the legs apart and then close them back together to do that, and you especially need to get into the vehicle mode. But you split those off, you do that, you fold the motorcycle front down. The arms don't particularly go anywhere, so you're just gonna fold them down and collapse. And I just knocked that off its ball joint, so hold on a second. Ugh, very, very tight joints on this toy. So you're just gonna fold the arms down and just put them into position that gets them out of the way of the what will be the arm articulation. You take the hand, you put it back in, but since we've made it, we're doing it this way, we are gonna fold the fingers out and then flip the heel piece around this way to make it the thumb. And there you have Groove in his arm mode, and you can rotate it this way and then just flip all of that around, and you can get a left arm as well, but I transformed it into being a right arm, so that's what we're going to do. And you can see all the stuff going on with Groove like so. And then for combined arm articulation, he is able to hinge. For whatever reason, when this is connected like that, he only gets one ratcheted tick, so he can't really bend his arms out that far because of that. But he is the ratchet that will allow his arm to rotate like that. still works perfectly. The waist articulation becomes an arm swivel, so the arm is able to swivel 360, and the knees and the hips allow the arm to bend like so. You can get 90 degrees out of that, and you can get 90 degrees out of that if you really want the arm to bend like that. It's a little, looks a little weird, but like you got a double jointed elbow, and it's a very weirdly double jointed elbow, but it exists. And then the hand, it can bend out like that, and then the fingers are able to bend like that, and you can get the thumb to articulate a bit like that, and then you can get it to articulate like that. And there are ports. There's a port right there. You can see all the way through, and you can put guns in there. And since it also flips on the other side, you can also put a gun underneath, though, because of Groove's, how Groove's feet work, you can't like properly have him hold weapons like that. But yeah, that's the arm mode, and then we're gonna just keep going on and finish getting to the robot mode. So we're gonna pull that foot out. We're gonna rotate the waist like this, and then we are going to split the legs like so. We're gonna come. We're gonna flip, fold the arms up, rotate them so the hands are facing forward. Repeat that on the other side. We'll come back here, untab that. So as we get enough clearance to flip the combiner peg down into the chest, then rotate Groove's head around, and then collapse the cockpit, the front of the motorcycle, down. And there we have Groove in his robot mode, and he looks pretty nice. He's very nice. He's got some nice silver going on. He's got some nice brownish gold going on his chest. His face is pretty neat. He's got a black helmet, a yellow face going on, and he's got an entirely clear black head, but like, there's a little bit of yellow in there so that he gets a bit of a yellow light piping effect going on. Like I said, his arms are, there's a lot of silver going on in his arms, though. The hinge and the fists are white, which I'm not sure if I like that, but it works. It's good. It doesn't like clash or anything. It's just like, I would think at least this would probably be silver, but this looks painted, I guess. That might be painted silver, so that would be really bad on a hinge joint like that. There is an Autobot symbol right there, again with a silver border background. There's a little bit of silver paint on the thighs, and then all of this you saw is the motorcycle, and then there's the bottom of the feet. There's the inside of the wheels, if you really want to see that. And then you get the backpack, and you got a lot of backpack going on. And for articulation, I said it is able to rotate a full 360, and not really a whole lot of wiggle waggle like the Time Masters do, but he is able to nod a little bit. He's got ball jointed shoulders, so his arms are able to rotate full 360, and he's able to get them out that far. But you can also, however, use the shoulder hinge to get him to extend more out. But it's also on a heavy ratchet. A heavy ratchet, which I'm not sure why they really need a heavy ratchet for that, but hey, he's got it. There is a swivel on the bicep, and he's able to swivel like that, and then his arms are able to bend 90 degrees at this pin for the elbow, and then his wrists don't do anything. At 360 degree waist articulation, his hips are also on a ball joint, and they're able to bend that far forward, and that far back, and that far out. There is a thigh swivel. It's able to rotate a full 360. His knees are able to bend at 90 degrees. And he has no ankle or foot articulation because he really doesn't have like distinct feet. It's just one solid thing right there. I'm actually slightly curious what would constitute his feet. Would these black bits move with his feet, or would it just be these flat black bits at the bottom there? I don't know, but he's got all of that, and you're able to do nice poses with him if you want. He is able to hold his weapons, as he should. He's actually able to hold all of his weapons at once, so you can put the weapons in like so, and you can take the hand-foot gun, and there's a 5mm post on the... If I don't drop the weapon, I can show it to you. There's a 5mm post at the bottom of his arm, and you can tab that right in. And then, boom, he's holding all of his weapons. And that's a little weird. He can't do that on the other side because that's where the kickstand goes. But he's able to hold all three of the weapons. But I did forget to mention before, there are 5mm posts there. And I'm pretty sure this is also a 5mm post. Let me just double check that. Yeah, that there's a lot of different combinations you can get with going on with this guy. So you can do stuff like that. You can do stuff like that. You can get this weapon in and you can get all kinds of crazy combinations in, but they're also able to combine in a bunch of different ways. None of them look particularly good, but it is there and an option for you if you want to do so, because he can only hold his weapons. There's nowhere to store them on his back. There's nowhere to store them in the vehicle mode either, in case you were curious, except for like on the sides for the guns. Those are the only places to store them. But anyway, let's get on to some robot mode size comparisons. Here he is with Legends class Bumblebee. And you can see Bumblebee comes like right to that the base of that connector peg. Pretty much. Here he is with Legends class Chrome Dome. If Chrome Dome isn't trying to do a full split right there. They're pretty much the same head height. They're pretty much standing head to head. There. Here he is with Voyager class Megatron. And he comes up to the base of that gray plate, like most Deluxes do. Here he is with Leader Class 6 Shot. I'm gonna move the Mac a little bit. And you can see he comes up to like that, that line right there on the skirt panel, pretty much with that head. And of course, here he is with the channel's mascots, Soundwave and Wheeljack. And you can see how he looks next to them. If I get the camera stationary. So, yeah, Groove is a very interesting, very nice Combiner Wars figure. This mold was basically made for Japan, I'd say, because this mold never saw a regular retail release in the US. He was only available online through the Hasbro Toy Shop, and the other use of the mold that appeared in the States was in the Computron box set for Lightspeed, and that was retooled a bit. But this is a very nice mold. It is definitely out of scale, so if you are one that is concerned with scale, which I don't know why you're into Transformers if you are concerned with the scale between all of your Transformers, but a very nice mold, nice to hold his accessories. His accessories are very nice. The motorcycle mode works. It's, like I said, it's a little mostly just kind of a robot with motorcycle bits. It's beefy, and I do catch myself not thinking motorcycles are not, like, that section of the motorcycle is not that beefy, but certainly his is not, like, covered with like engine detailing or looking parts or whatnot. It's just there. But that's the only kind of complaint I really have with him. Like I said, he's pretty nice. The weapons are nice. And that's all I have to say on Protectobot Groove. So thank you for watching. If you enjoyed, please like and share this video and subscribe to the channel. You can also follow me on Twitter and Instagram at SoundJack426. Also, please consider donating on my Patreon page to help support the channel. All of the links will be in the description below. Thanks for tuning in. This is SoundJack, signing off.